Very exciting time to be in multiple myeloma, I think. And you're just coming back from ASCO, so you heard data on the CASTOR study, and this is the POLLUX study. So these were the two large phase three randomized trials. CASTOR, as you know, was in combination with bortezomib, and this one, daratumumab, is being combined with lenalidomide and dexamethasone here. And so I'm just going to tell you what's in the abstract because I don't want to take away from Thanos's presentation later on this evening is the fact that patients who got daratumumab in combination with lenalidomide and dexamethasone had more than a doubling in terms of their response rate. What was quite striking was the progression-free survival and the duration of response. The PFS has not even been reached, so the median, and it's way up in the 70% and 80% range, so that's quite remarkable. And if you look at the RevDex arm, has done incredibly well as well, much better than some of the phase three studies which we've recently seen late last year, like the Tourmaline study or the Eloquent trials, where typically the RevDex control arm is about 14 or 15 months, depending on which study you look at. In this POLLUX study, the RevDex arm has gone close to 17 and a half months, very similar to Aspire. And despite that, the RevDex Dara arm has done incredibly well, and we haven't even reached the median as yet. So I think that's exciting. The other important piece is, you know, when you combine this monoclonal antibody with some of these other backbone drugs that we use in multiple myeloma, it's not as if you augment toxicity, you really don't. And most of the toxicity is the initial toxicity that you see with the monoclonal antibody, but you really improve response rates and the duration of responses in these patients. And honestly, the future is going to be combining. So we've always known that we're going to be combining this antibody with whatever drugs we have. CASTOR, as you saw, again, remarkable results there. You know, the Vel/Dex arm had a PFS of a little over seven and a half months, I believe, and I don't think the median has been reached with Dara with Vel/Dex. So just adding a monoclonal antibody to whatever existing drugs we have is doubling response rates for sure, but also improving progression-free survival dramatically, so that both of these studies have a hazard ratio of about 0.31, 0.35, suggesting a 70% improvement in their responses. That's amazing.